All right. Good morning, FitFam. How are you? And I hope that you can see my screen. So basically, right now, everybody's probably feeling pretty sore, including myself. Now, first, I want to know how many of us out there are really, really, really sore. So this week we did isolations. We did a lot of legs. Some of us did a killer workout on Saturday where we worked with Coach Caliente. And then we came out to the hill, or we were over at Assiniboine Park with Big Mama. But either way, I want to know right now who's really sore. So comment in the box below. Also, I want you to comment, where are you sore? I want to know, where are you most sore by the end of the week so that I can develop stretching and recovery routines so that we can get your legs, your hips, your knees, your feet, your ankles, your wrists, your neck, whatever it is. I want you to comment in the comment sections where you are the most sorest. So it's Sunday today, and Sunday to me is a rest and recovery day. Yesterday actually was a rest and recovery day. I was just completely bagged, and I was actually in bed by 8 p.m. Woke up this morning at 5 a.m. and I feel like a million bucks. And so I am ready to take on Monday, crush it, and just be an awesome coach. So here's what you're gonna do to speed your recovery. Number one is a supplement that we're using, which is called Tissue Rejuvenator. Now you've probably heard me talk about this over and over again, and it's kind of a big deal. And it's one of the supplements that you'll probably take for the rest of your life. Now here's the reason. It's got three major ingredients that you would have to go to Costco or Walmart and buy them individually that specifically go into your joints and they add lubrication. It's also got something in there called turmeric. So turmeric is a natural anti-inflammatory. And when you take this natural anti-inflammatory, you're gonna feel less pain and you're gonna be able to recover faster and work out harder. It's also got collagen in there, which collagen strengthens your connective tissue. So everything from your skin to your tendons and joints. So when you're taking this tissue rejuvenator, and we do have it for sale at the gym, you'd first start off with just two before you go to bed, and then you would start taking four a day. And you would just consistently take four a day. Unless you're not really sore, then you can go back down to two. But my recommendation is that you take four a day, regardless of it. Now I'm going to tell you how you're going to be able to take a break. So that's the number one supplement that I would recommend. Excuse me. Next is to take a break. So you need to recharge and reset. And what that means is that you take a break from everything, right? If you're extremely, extremely sore, I'm talking like an 8, 9, or a 10, and you try to force a 100% workout in, and it even gets worse when you start taking supplements such as caffeine. So if you're drinking coffee to get you fired up, if you're taking supplements such as ephedrine to get you fired up, or even pre-workout, and you're already at an 8, 9, 10 before you walk in there being sore and tired, you're just gonna make yourself worse. And I'm a big promoter of taking 2 days off a week. It's the only way that my brain and my body can rest and recharge and for me to be the best versions of myself. Doesn't mean that I'm taking it fully off. I'll go into that next, but it does mean that I do reset and recharge. And so when it comes to any of these Sundays, for me, that's generally when I won't take any supplements. The only real supplements that I'll take on Sundays is number one is I'll decrease the amount of caffeine that I take in. I don't generally drink coffee, but I will drink tea. And so for me, I'll drink 2 cups of tea when I normally drink 4 cups of tea Monday through Friday. I also won't be taking my amino IQs. So during the week, I have heavy meetings in the midday. I also do gym coaching. So I coach hundreds of other gym owners out there worldwide. And so for me, I have to be on top of my game for that midday. So I take the Amino IQ to wake me up and to kind of give me a little bit of mental focus, but it's also got caffeine in there. So I would generally do 1 to 2 servings of that middle of the day. Today, that doesn't exist. Ephedrine. I generally take that when I work out or when I coach. I'll take anywhere from 3 to 5 Monday through Friday. And today, nothing. So as you can see, it's just a rest recharge day. And it might be a crappy day for you depending on how reliant you are on that and also how much sleep deprivation you had. So if you went to bed late Friday and you went to bed late Saturday, Sunday is going to be a rough. And if you drank more than you normally do on Saturday, or if you ate more food than you normally do on Saturday, then Sunday's going to be a rough day. But sometimes you got to go through a little bit of pain to get to where you need to be, right? It's just like sore is sexy. Sore equals sexy. If you get a little bit sore or you get a lot of sore, then the faster results you're going to get, right? But then we take days like this to rest and recharge. So that's what I would tell you right off the bat. Okay. So rest, recharge, try to either get right off of any supplements outside of tissue rejuvenator or anything that is a stimulant. Try to get off of those on at least one day a week. Even if you got to power through a workout without them, I would highly suggest that. Okay. Then I want you to get mobile. So that means that try and get at least 5,000 steps today, right? Normally Monday through Friday, I like everybody to get 10,000 steps. On a Sunday, I'd like to see you get like 5 to 10,000 steps. Once you get to 10,000, that's when your body, you're starting to add to the soreness. So 5,000 is where I would tell you to be. 10,000 on a regular workday. Number two is a mobility routine. So what I'm actually going to do in the comments is post a mobility routine, and I'm kind of seeing feet, right? So Ali saying feet, Guy saying ankle. So, you know, Caroline is saying booty, right? Of course. Well, you've been crushing it all week. So, but that's fine. I'm going to post my ankle and foot mobility. It's not going to crazy stretch you out, but it's going to get your joints, and it's going to get your ankles mobile, and it's also probably going to break up some scar tissue. So get mobile today, get moving, try not just to be completely inactive, just enough to get the blood flowing. The best cure for sore muscles or any type of injuries is small movements. And then the last is you got to sleep, right? So tonight, the first thing, I don't care what time you go to bed, you might have a hard time going to sleep. But I would tell you that you need to stop eating at 6 p.m. because all of us have to get up fairly early tomorrow, I would assume, unless you're working overnights. But for the majority of the people that are here on this call, you've got to wake up fairly early tomorrow. And that means that you don't want anything being digested and being released. And so I would just tell you the quick rule of thumb is stop eating at 6 p.m. So if you got to break your fast early today, say start eating at 10, whatever it might be, then that's fine. But then you stop. Your last piece of food that you eat stops at 6 p.m. This way, even if you went and had an ice cream cake, that it wouldn't really affect you when you went to bed at 9 or 10. Probably most people are probably going to bed around 10 now. For me to go to bed at 9 is very tough because of the sunlight's out. But, you know, I'll take something to put me to sleep, like a melatonin on a lower level, gravel on a higher level, or a Zoloft, if anybody knows what those are, depending on how fast I need to go to sleep. But those are my three levels and hacks of how to get to sleep faster. So that's it, everybody. It's your Sunday. Rest, recharge, and then take this theory, take it throughout the week, and make this a staple for what you do moving forward. And if you do that, I guarantee you, you're going to recover faster. When you recover faster, you're going to be able to work out harder. And when you work out harder, you're going to get more sore. And when you get more sore, you're going to get more sexy.